Achieving optimal cluster density for your sequencing runs is the first step in maximizing the output and efficiency of your Illumina sequencing instrument. Hello, I'm Tim Gilmartin, a staff field application scientist with Illumina.
And I'm Michelle Ye, a staff technical application scientist with Illumina. In this video, we will discuss optimal cluster density and how over and under clustering can affect your sequencing data. We will then examine common clustering issues and ways to prevent them. Please use the Cluster Optimization Overview Guide found on the Illumina Support website as the official cluster optimization resource. Let's go back to Tim to discuss optimal cluster density.
Thanks, Michelle. One of the most critical metrics in assessing sequencing run performance is cluster density. This metric impacts both data quality and total yield due to its effect on the number of reads passing filter and the percent of those reads that remain high quality. Overclustering increases signal brightness, which makes it difficult for the instrument's optics to find the correct focal plane. This can cause poor cluster identification, known as template generation, poor registration, and other image analysis issues. Let's take a closer look on how this can negatively affect sequencing data. First, overloaded signal intensities decrease the ratio of base intensity to background. This creates ambiguity during base culling and decreases data quality, leading to lower percent greater than Q30. Next, overclustered flow cells typically have more overlapping clusters, which leads to poor signal purity from each cluster, and thus poor template generation. This decreases the percent of clusters passing filter, or percent PF. A lower percent PF ultimately reduces run output. Also, index reads typically have lower diversity, which can cause poor base calling. Since overclustering worsens the potential for poor base calling, this can lead to demultiplexing failure. Finally, when overclustering is extreme, image focusing can fail and terminate the run at any cycle, resulting in a run failure. As you can see, overclustering can have a significant impact on sequencing data. As for underclustering, these runs still maintain high data quality, but lower data output. In general, underclustering is preferable to overclustering because these effects are less severe. If optimal loading concentration is unknown for a library type, it's best to load at a conservative concentration for the first sequencing run. Let's go to Michelle for more on recommended cluster densities.
Thanks, Tim. Performing a run at optimal cluster density involves finding a balance between underclustering and overclustering. Ideally, we want to sequence at a high enough density to maximize total data output while maintaining a low enough density to avoid overclustering. Illumina has these recommended target densities for our non-pattern flow cells. Raw cluster density is displayed here in thousands of clusters per square millimeter and measures how many clusters are identified on the flow cell regardless of whether they pass quality filter. Now let's discuss some common clustering issues and how to prevent them from decreasing data quality and yield from your sequencing runs.
Okay, let's first talk about library quality. Library preparations that undergo insufficient library cleanup leave contaminants such as adapter dimers, primer dimers, or partial library constructs in the final library pool. In this case, quantification of cluster-generating fragments can be inaccurate due to these contaminants, which can lead to inconsistent cluster densities. Be sure to verify the quality and purity of all libraries using the method described in the appropriate library prep documentation. Commonly, bioanalyzer, tape station, or a fragment analyzer can be used to check the library integrity, average insert size, and unexpected contaminant peaks, as seen at the 120 base pair peak in this example.
Next, we'll review common issues resulting from library quantification. Even with a high-quality sequencing library, inaccurate library quantification will still lead to suboptimal or inconsistent clustering. There are multiple quantification methods available for next-generation sequencing. The main three methods are qPCR, fluorometric-based methods such as qubit or picogreen, and automated electrophoresis analyzers such as bioanalyzer. Recommended quantification methods can vary between different library preps due to a number of factors, such as expected size range of the final library and amplification methods. The following table provides general guidance for using the different quantification methods and can be found in the Cluster Optimization Overview Guide. Remember to always refer to your library prep documentation for product-specific recommendations and instructions. It is important to note that Illumina does not recommend spectrophotometry methods, such as nanodrop, to quantify sequencing libraries. Those quantifications include single-stranded nucleic acids and free nucleotides, so these methods can overestimate library concentration and lead to inconsistent cluster densities. See the expert video tip, "How do I achieve consistent quantitation, part one," for more details. Now let's examine common issues loading concentration can cause. The loading concentration is the final concentration of a library loaded onto an instrument for sequencing. Depending on the system, recommended loading concentrations can be found in the Denature and Dilute Guide or the System Guide.
Depending on the cluster density resulting from using the recommended loading concentrations, you may need to adjust the concentration to optimize data output. It's important to adjust loading concentrations in small increments. This is because the relationship between loading concentration and cluster density is nonlinear, as can be seen in this chart of example data for the MySeq V2 chemistry. Here, the broken blue line represents the incorrect assumption of a linear relationship, and the orange line represents the observed relationship for this instrument in chemistry. Assuming a linear relationship when adjusting loading concentration can lead to overclustering and a corresponding drop in percent clusters passing filter, reducing output. Achieving optimal cluster density likely requires a small empirical adjustment to determine optimum loading concentration. Another consideration in arriving at final loading concentration is denaturation. Sequencing libraries commonly use sodium hydroxide to denature the library to prepare hybridization to a flow cell. It is important to ensure that fresh sodium hydroxide with a pH of 12.5 or greater is used. Sodium hydroxide that is not freshly diluted can acidify and impair denaturation. Libraries with incomplete denaturation have fewer strands available to bind and cluster on the flow cell, reducing cluster density. Also, ensure the final concentration of sodium hydroxide in the diluted libraries is less than 1 millimolar. Excess sodium hydroxide in the diluted library can inhibit cluster formation. In fact, the NextSeq 550 Denature and Dilution Guide uses TRIS-HCl to neutralize the pH, and this process can be adopted for dilute and denature protocols with other Illumina instruments if needed.
Let's also consider how nucleotide diversity can impact clustering. Illumina bases cluster density recommendations on diverse libraries. Diverse libraries are those that have relatively even proportions of each nucleotide A, T, C, and G. Low diversity libraries, or libraries that have an uneven proportion of nucleotides across the flow cell from one cycle to the next, can compromise software performance and data accuracy. When sequencing low diversity libraries, Illumina recommends two strategies to improve data quality. Reduce the loading concentration relative to the level recommended for diverse libraries, and spike in PhiX or other high diversity library to provide a more balanced signal as shown in this table. The Illumina support website hosts a wealth of resources for optimizing sequencing with low nucleotide diversity. Additional support bulletins, technical notes, and video tips to help you optimize clustering and sequencing with low diversity libraries are listed in the YouTube description below. Finally, let's see how XAMPP preparation can impact clustering. For workflows that require manually mixing exclusion amplification or XAMPP reagents, improper prep can impact clusters passing filter and other metrics like occupancy. Be sure to follow instructions for preparing XAMPP reagents carefully using specified volumes and durations. We hope this video contained helpful information about achieving optimal cluster density for your sequencing runs.
For more on diagnosing suboptimal clustering issues in either patterned or non-patterned flow cells, check out the videos linked in the description. And thanks for being part of the Illumina community.